What is going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Today, we're going to be talking about Sparkle. How does she compare to Bronya? And we're also going to be getting into some live calculations for Zila and then comparing how does she do with Bronya and then how does she does with Sparkle. So if you like that type of content, let me know by leaving a comment in the comment section below and subscribing to the channel. Let's get right into it. First things first, we're going to discuss what Sparkle does, starting with her basic, deals quantum damage. But the important part here is that it regenerates 30 energy instead of the usual 20. And with an energy recharge rope, that's going to be around 36. Honestly, I don't think you're going to be using the basic too often, but it's still good that you can regenerate 30 energy instead of the usual 20. At the same time, you are regenerating a skill point when you use it. All right, next up, we got the skill increases crit damage by 24% of Sparkle's crit damage plus 45% until the start of the ally's next turn. This is a main point of comparison with Bronya. This effect until the start of the ally's next turn, this is what Bronya does at E6, which means that whatever buff that this amount of crit damage that you're going to get from Sparkle skill, it lasts until the beginning of next turn. So it's really, really nice. It makes it to where follow-up attackers actually get to enjoy the benefits of this skill. It also is going to action advance by 50%. Essentially, it says 50%, right? But essentially, it means taking a turn, because the only way you would not take a turn here is if Sparkle is twice as fast as your DPS. And that would never happen, because unless Sparkle has 200 speed or 180 speed and your DPS has 90, that's the only way you wouldn't take a turn. Since usually you're going to run her like as fast as you can, let's say a generous amount of speed would be like, I don't know, like 160, 161 is the general threshold as we have over here. If you run her 161 and your DPS is at 134 or not even 134, you can have it at 120, 110 or whatever, you're still going to pretty much take a turn immediately after Sparkle. So that's really nice. So it has the same action advance effect that Bronya has for the most part, and also gives you some crit damage to go. For this test, we're going to assume that she has 180 crit damage in her stats. So that will yield a total of 48.8% crit damage when uses the skill whenever we are do the calculations later on. Okay, Sparkle actually has one of the craziest ults in the game. It recovers 4 skill points, and then the damage boost from the talent gets it an extra 10% per stack. We're going to discuss that in a second, but essentially just recovers 4 skill points with 110 energy cost by itself. It's insane. Since we mentioned the talent, what the talent does is that increases your skill point cap by 2. So normally it's 5 skill point cap, so now you're going to have up to 7 skill points, which is amazing. And then you're going to get a damage bonus plus 6% per skill point consumed by a maximum of 3, and it lasts for 2 turns. So every time you consume a skill point, Sparkle is going to give the entire team 6% damage buff, and it stacks up to 3 times. So let's say for Infibula Lunae, he uses 3 skill points, you get 18% damage bonus just by him going. Also, it increases the attack percentage by 15% to the entire party, and then it further increases your attack by 5, 15, and 30% if there are 1, 2, or 3 quantum characters on the team. And this part right here only applies to the quantum character. So if you have, let's say, Sparkle and Fuxuan, you have 2, so it'd be 15 plus the 15, but the 30% only applies to Fuxuan and Sparkle. It does not apply to your DPS if the DPS is not quantum. So this part, this whole section over here only applies to quantum characters, which is why people are saying she's not as good for Infibula Lunae as whatever. This part doesn't matter. This part could not be here for all intents and purposes. And Infibula Lunae is still going to be like insane with Sparkle. All right, and last but not least, in her kit, she makes the enemies not attack you. It pretty much makes you invisible, kind of like how Zila does. And then when you enter battle, you recover 3 skill points. So that's pretty insane. Her rotation is pretty much just skill spam until you get an ult. That's pretty much what it is. And then with an energy regen rope, you're going to get your ult every 3 skills. There's no more way, you can't make it faster, and then adding more energy regen will not make it faster either way. So running the Penacony because of the energy is not really worth it. Just the energy regen rope is good, but you may still want to run Penacony if you are going to run quantum characters in the first place. So that's another thing to consider. But just know that the extra 5% energy does nothing for her. She gets a 3-turn ultimate every 3 turns, regardless of having the 5% or not. Over here in the stats table, we are stats that you want to shoot for. She only wants to focus on speed and crit damage. That's all you want on her. And then the thresholds are 134. So you can get that extra action on the first cycle, 144, and then 161. So you can get extra actions in the second cycle. Then as far as crit damage, we're going to test this with 180%. And then like I said earlier, this translates to about 88% crit damage bonus, which is quite hefty. All right, lastly, this little square right here is pretty much what I just talked about over here, but condensed down. She can get you up to 48% damage bonus, 88.2% crit damage, 15% attack for the entire team. And if you're quantum, you can get up to 45, 50% action advance, which pretty much translates into getting a turn. and then at bare minimum plus one SP positive. And what I mean by that is, like, if you don't start off with her kit, right? If you don't start off with your tech, you start off at 3 skill points, right? She's going to use 1 skill point per turn. So 1 skill point, 2 skill points, 3 skill points. And then she's going to ult and go back up to 4. Then use 3 more, go back up to 5. Use 3 more and go back up to 6. So she's always going to be a plus 1 SP positive. That's what I mean by it. All right, for this video, I'm going to compare a Sparkle's damage formula and what she adds to Bronya. So what we're going to do is we're going to take Zila's kit. And then we're going to run her numbers. And then put him down right here. And then at the end, we're going to make a comparison. As you can notice, I also have Dr. Ratio, Jing Liu, and Don Hongi Ribbit Lune. However, calculating this the same way we're going to do Zila, it's a little bit more complicated. As you can see, Ribbit Lune is just a crazy fest of calculations. Every tick of damage for him is a different calculation. And it's just insane. So it was going to be too much for this video. So I just decided to go for Zila, which is still a lot for one video because her calculations are crazy. It's like resurgence, not resurgence, resurgence, not resurgence. So it's kind of like crazy, but we're going to do it anyway. Okay. All right. For the first part of the calculation, we're going to calculate Zila's basic skill and ultimate with resurgence without any buffs. And that is going to give us our baseline. So for this is really easy. All we have to do is add resurgence. And for resurgence, she gets 20% damage penetration here. So we're going to add it on both sides. And then she also gets a 40% damage bonus. So let's add that on both sides. It should be the same number. So the total number is going to be 4,041.71 for her basic. All right, now that we added resurgence, all we have to do is tweak the multipliers to reflect the skill and the ultimate, and then that's how we're gonna get the baseline for those as well. So for the skill, it's going to be 220 and 220, and then that's gonna give us our ultimate, so we're just gonna copy and paste this over here, and this is gonna be the skill. And then for the ultimate is 425, which is kind of a hefty multiplier if you ask me, so. 17k. Okay, cool. All right, now I'm gonna do a formula to pretty much add this up. All right, so our total comes out to 30,000, right? 30,100 something. Okay, so this is going to be our total. Now what we're going to do is we're going to systematically add in Sparkle, and then after that we're going to add Bronya. Okay, we're going to start off with the attack because it's a more complicated one. How it works is that attack increases, or percentage attack increases, base of Zila's base attack and her light cone base attack. And then for this particular scenario, we did Cruising in the Stellar Sea, which has a base attack of 529, and then Zila is like I don't know, like 600 something. So I know the total is 1169, so we're gonna go ahead and calculate what 30% of 1169 is, which I'm going to do outside of here. So we had an extra 3350, and then Bronya does 55% attack increase. So let's go ahead and add that. So 1169, it's an extra 643. So 3,643. Boom. So now we have Sparkle's attack increase and Bronya's attack increase. And remember, this is just a scenario where it's just them two, Sparkle and Bronya, and then Bronya, I mean, Sparkle and Zila, and then Bronya and Zila. The next thing is going to be the extra crit damage that they provide. Sparkle add 180 crit damage. We'll be providing Zila with 88.2% extra crit damage. And with 180% crit damage, Bronya is going to provide 48% extra crit damage to Zila. Now for extra damage boost, Sparkle is going to be providing 48% damage boost to Zila. And then Bronya is going to be providing 76 because she does 66 with her skill, and then 10% because she's Bronya, you know? And then that will be our totals. Okay, so here we go. 425% for the ultimate gives us 38,000. Let's copy this and paste it here. And then we are going to copy this and paste it there. Boom. Now the skill is 220%. So let's go ahead and fix that. 220%. Boom. And they're pretty close, about 300 off. Let's paste that there. And then let's copy and paste. Copy pasta. Oh, wait, let me fix these formulas real quick. Okay, and then lastly, we have the basic, which is 100%. Bada bim, bada boom. So the totals is going to be 67,000 on this one, almost 68,000. And this one's almost, it's only 1,000 difference when we compare Zila with resurgence. Well, this is Sparkle Zila with resurgence. And then this would be Bronya Zila with resurgence. And now let's calculate what the damage percentage is going to be. So let me just do that off cam. Okay, so when I calculate what is the app overall damage increase over the three skills, it's an average of 124 for Sparkle and then 128 for Bronya. So obviously Bronya comes out on top because she has the higher damage multipliers. However, this doesn't paint the whole picture because Bronya's thing is that she uses a lot of skill points and so does Zila. So we have to make it kind of like a simulated scenario because just because she gives us a better damage increase buff doesn't mean that she's actually going to provide better DPS. The best example of this is Ting, Yukong. Yukong gives you a massive DPS increase in just one turn when she does her ultimate, but after that, she's kind of like dead in the water for a little bit, you know? So for this, I took the liberty of calculating over three turns what the skills are going to be and then what is the overall damage. And then I took into consideration a few different scenarios with Sparkle and also a few different scenarios with Bronya. And these are the ones that I saw that had the most like viability. So we're gonna discuss both of them right now. All right, let's talk about Bronya first because there's a few ways how you can play this and it's actually very complex with the whole resurgence, not resurgence thing. And then the Bronya scaling and then ulting and all that stuff. So Bronya is going to start off the fight with three skill points. She's going to basic to generate a skill point into four skill points. Zila's gonna take that turn, use a skill point into three skill points. And then Zila's gonna do a trigger resurgence, hopefully to kill something. Trigger resurgence, using another skill point, that's what the two is here. And then here, I put it in yellow because here we actually need to insert an ally to generate a skill point for us because next turn is the one that we're gonna use to do our big PP damage. So end of turn skill points would be three after the ally generated the skill point. We start the next turn with Bronya with three skill points into scale ult because she's going to have it. This is an MOC 12, by the way, that you start off with half your energy bar. You're going to ult there, and now you're going to go into a Zila skill without resurgence because you haven't killed anything. Hopefully you kill something into another Zila skill. Now this one is in red because if we didn't have this ally generate the skill point, we would be in zero. So this wouldn't happen. This would have to be a basic. And then from the basic, you would have one skill point into Zila ult. But since you do, you go from one, this actually goes to zero, and then you have to skill here to generate a skill point, and then here you're gonna have to Zila ult over here. So this is pretty much like you only have one big chunky turn where you do most of your damage, and then you have two turns in between where you have to kind of cool, like you kind of have to cool down because you just don't have enough skill points unless you just use. So for this, I had to insert another ally because it would not be possible with just Bronya and Zila, okay? And then as you can notice, like the damage is like really low and then high and then low. Now let's take a look at Sparkle. Turn one, she's going to start off with her tech, giving her three skill points off rip. So you're starting the turn with six. You use one to bring Zila up, skill into another skill with the Surgeons. Let's assume that you kill something. And then you can also ult in this one because you can skill twice. And you also have the Sparkle buff here. So ulting here is not out of the question. The reason I did this here, you're gonna notice down here, you get to squeeze in a second ult because Zila can ult every four skills. And with this little setup, you're able to ult twice. And the first ult doesn't have full Sparkle buffs, but the second one does. So here we have an ult over here, and then you end the turn with three skill points. So three skill points come around. Because you use your ult outside of your extra turn, you trigger resurgence again. So Zila's gonna get another turn with resurgence. Doesn't matter if she kills or not, she got a turn. Now Sparkle's gonna come back up, two skill points. She's going to skill Zila all the way back up and then ult right there, generating four more skill points. So from two, she goes down to one, but then ults and goes back up to five. After that, Zila's already there. She's gonna take a turn and then Zila's going to skill without resurgence, hopefully killing something into a Zila skill with resurgence. And then that yields you at 44,000 in this turn. And then the next turn would start, turn three. Sparkle's going to skill. Remember, we still have Sparkle ult here. And by this point, we have full Sparkle buffs. And then here's where we have the big PP Zila turn, which is Sparkle skill into Zila skill without resurgence, into Zila skill with resurgence, into Zila's ult with resurgence. And as you can see, the big PP damage turn from Sparkle does less damage than the big PP turn from Bronya. However, that is not the only turn that they have. Like that in Sparkle, you have multiple turns where you do like decent amounts of damage. Like you have high turn, kind of mid turn, and then high turn. Here is low turn, high turn, low turn. And it's all because of skill points. If Bronya didn't have the skill points issue, then they would, like, Bronya would probably be better, you know? But she does, and this is E0, S0. E1, S1, you may trigger the skill here, or you may not. The only guaranteed skill point that you're going to have is over here, which would be enough to get this, to mitigate this, by the way. So if you have S1 for Bronya, it is possible to do it without the ally, because you get the extra skill point from the ult. But E0, S0, how I'm treating Sparkle over here, clearly Sparkle is just the better support here for Zilla. I am also not taking into consideration that I only calculated 2 quantum units instead of 3. So if you run a mono quantum team, you're going to get the full 45% attack bonus. So this wouldn't be 3,350. It would be a little bit higher, be 15% higher than this. So it doesn't paint the full picture. During the 3 turns, Sparkle yields 179,000 damage with Zilla, and then Bronya is 100,000. I know what you're gonna say. There's a few different ways where you can make this higher. However, I try to make it as skill point efficient to get this turn right here. This turn right here, I only saw it possible with this setup right here. Because if you start off with skills, by the time you have Bronya ult, you're gonna have to waste a turn just to get skill points back up so you can scale 3 times. So that would happen on turn 4. It wouldn't happen on turn 3. So this is what I decided to go for because it made more sense. And if we add another turn on turn 4, like Sparkle's damage is probably gonna end up being higher anyway, because she can still do the same thing again. So it is what it is. She was definitely made for for quantum characters, for one. And second, for characters that want to use skill points. That's what essentially Sparkle was made for. I am doing better calculations with Dr. Ratio, Jing Liu, and Don Hong, but these to simulate these is going to be such a pain, because each instance of damage for Don Hong is just a different calculation. It changes every tick of damage, so it's really tough to calculate. But you're going to notice the same trend, like Sparkle is going to yield less damage overall, but over the course of 3 to 4 turns, Sparkle is going to outperform, because you can consistently use skill points throughout those 4 turns, especially with follow-up units. For Dr. Ratio, for example, the skill up into the Bronya skill into Dr. Ratio skill into follow-up, that's all boosted. That is all good. Bronya can support that. Where Sparkle starts taking over is whenever we factor in Dr. Ratio's ultimate. Because his ultimate, when he follow-ups after his Wise Man Folly, all of those are after he took his turn. All while Sparkle's buff are still active, but Bronya's buffs are not. Those follow-up attacks that trigger with Wise Man's Folly are all going to be boosted by Sparkle, which is going to yield a more damage. One character that I expect this to remain the same, and Bronya will still be the number one support, is going to be characters like Jing Liu, because they are unaffected by skill point consumption, because Bronya uses the skill points that Jing Liu doesn't need. Jing Liu uses 1 skill point at the beginning of the battle, and if you run her with Hua Hua and Ting Yun, she never uses another skill point until the battle's over, because she does so much damage that in 2 to 3 turns, everything's dead anyway. So she uses 1 skill point in the beginning, and then she doesn't use skill points ever again, pretty much. So she doesn't really need somebody that uses skill points, and that's why Bronya is her best friend. Same thing with Blade. Blade is another character that Bronya is still going to be better with. But when it comes to Don Hong, we all know how difficult it is to use Bronya with Don Hong, because he is as skill point hungry as you can get, and so is Bronya. Bronya wants to use her skill every turn, but when you play them together, you're gonna have to like pick when you're gonna burst your damage. So with Sparkle, I don't think that's going to be that big of an issue. He's still going to have to take a few turns, or maybe 1 turn in between, to like not dish out a lot of damage, because using 3 skill points every turn, even at even when you get 2 for free, can get pretty expensive pretty quickly. But these calculations are not final. I still have to simulate the turns for all these. But it's like, it's a lot. Like, this took me a little bit, because I had to think of when Resurgence was up, when Resurgence was not up, when do I have Bronya skill, when do I have Sparkle skill and ult. It's just a lot of stuff that you have to like take into consideration. And I'm not even saying that this is perfect. I may have made a mistake or two in here as well. So, but this is just to show you that Sparkle's value when it comes to SP hungry or SP neutral DPSs, that sometimes is better than just Bronya. And then units like Zilla, who Bronya used to be her best friend, now she's going to have to be married to Sparkle if you have her, because it's just overall better. The damage is consistent over turns. It's not going to be ups and downs like this one. So let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. If I made a mistake, let me know. I'm all down for fixing my stuff. I don't want to put out wrong information. So let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. How are you pulling for Sparkle? Like, are you pulling for her? Like, are you excited for her? And until next time, guys. See ya.